Good morning. My name is Serge Przedborski, and I'm the chair of the Scientific Program Committee, and it's today my pleasure to be in presence of Dr. Rick Morimoto, who is this year the recipient of the David Marsden Lectureship. And it's a great pleasure for me because for many aspects, I think that neurobiology of disease is really becoming something that I believe is central to our progress and advance in movement disorder, but in academic medicines. And I think that, as we will discover during our short discussion today with Dr. Morimoto, really to have biologists involved in our effort, it's something critical. And so today, what I thought that we can do is to have a discussion with Dr. Morimoto. If you don't mind, I will call you Rick.
Call me Rick, please.
And I thought that maybe what I've personally always been fascinated with, and some of my students in my lab always fascinated with, it's how great people, great scientists, come to decide to go to science. I often said that at the beginning, we all want to be policemen or firemen working in this or that. But science is really something very particular. And it's always intriguing to me to understand when the passion or the interest for science started. So, Rick, I was wondering if you can tell us about how that started for you.
Well, first, Serge, let me thank you and the committee for the honor of the David Marsden Lectureship. So science for me, as far as I can tell, goes back to the very beginning. Turns out I didn't want to be a rocket scientist or a policeman or a football player. Somehow my parents always brought me to the library and I found myself interested in nature. And so as a child, I was always collecting bugs and interested in life just, you know, around me. Plants and flowers. And I grew up in Chicago. I was born and grew up in Chicago. And in that era, they had something called science fairs that are still popular in the schools these days everywhere. And the science fairs, I started when I was probably in the fifth grade. And I think I did something on bioluminescent. You know, you go in the backyard on a warm, humid day, and you see the fireflies lighting up. And you sit there and say, oh, that's interesting. How do they do that? And of course, as a child, you catch a few of them. You try to take them apart. And you realize when you take apart a firefly, it doesn't work anymore. But from those simple beginnings, you know, come curiosity that, well, how does this work? And over the years, then, as a high school student, I became so curious about science that in my senior year in high school, I decided I needed an electron microscope for a project. I wanted to examine the structure of a protist. I don't know why I got interested in this protist, but it was papers I was reading as a high school student, and I went to the University of Illinois in Chicago, knocked on the doors.
Well, you were at high school.
In high school. In high school, I knocked on the doors in my junior year of the different professors. And I would say, when they opened the door, I say, do you have an electron microscope? They look at me and they say, no. Finally, one man said, a Dr. Howard Busey said, yes, I have an electron microscope. And I said, well, I'd like to use it. He never said to me, you're too young, this is not possible. He just, what do you want to do? And he welcomed me into his laboratory, filled with graduate students and postdocs. And here I was, I think at that time, was 15 years old, and I was fascinated. So he left me alone to do experiments. I went to the International Science Fair that year, took third place in biochemistry, and met people who I've continued to be friends with in science ever since. And so I think going to college and doing science was a natural outgrowth. I went to the University of Illinois. I worked in the lab from the first day I started college. So I've always been curious about science. As it relates to how did I get to where I am now, there's really a moment. First is that I think we can all point towards specific people, mentors.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And there was an amazing high school teacher who just supported me. He knew that I was not coming to high school. He knew that instead of coming to high school, I was at the university.